friends, today we will start the 8th lesson, Evolving Sustainable Paradigm. So what is the meaning of sustainability? Sustainability is a capacity to endure. Or in ecological terms, it will describe the biological systems that remain productive and diverse over time. In simple words, sustainability or sustainable use of resources means, so we are using the resources without degrading the environment and we are conserving the resources for future generations. So sustainability means it is the capacity to endure. In ecology, it describes the biological systems that remain diverse and productive over time. So what is the meaning of sustainable development? So the development that meets the needs of the people without degrading the environment or without compromising the environment, without compromising anything, and also it conserves for future generation. So what are the impacts of modern development on the environment? So it destructs the forest, and destruction of forest leads to habitat destruction. Deforestation leads to soil erosion and also reduces transpiration. The emission levels increases, decreases in the groundwater level, rise in the global temperature, and that results in climate change, extinction of rare animals and species due to the poaching of animals, biopiracy, and that causes the destruction of habitats, increasing the number of diseases and also scarcity of food that results in starvation. What are the objectives of sustainable development? What are the objectives of sustainable development? It expresses the need to conserve for the future generation. It expresses the need to conserve for the future generation. More concern about the environmental protection. It is pro-stable economic growth. So it helps in the economic growth. Sustainable and justified use of resources, especially natural resources. It caters or fulfills the social progress that recognizes the need of everyone. What are the principles of sustainable development? So what are the principles of sustainable development? Conservation of ecosystems. Conservation of ecosystems. Minimizing the depletion of resources. Conservation of biodiversity. Conservation of biodiversity. Social justice should be provided to all. All human beings must adopt the energy saving and the resource conservation, conserving lifestyle. Uphold the fundamental human rights with respect to cultures, customs and values in dealing with employees and others who are affected by our activities or which are affected by human activities. What are the characteristic principles of sustainable development? First one is substitution. So substitution in the means, so we are replacing the non-renewable resources with renewable resources. So like solar energy, wind energy, so that the pollution level or the contamination of the environment will be reduced. Renewability. So whatever the resources we are using, so we have to use that resources and in such a way that it should have proper time to renew itself, or we have to provide the time to renew it. Next one, adaptability. So the people must adopt the lifestyle which by fulfilling our all needs, but without contaminating, without polluting the environment. And for example, instead of using disposable cups, we can adapt it to glass cups so that it will easily washed and we can reuse it. So we have to adopt the things which can be reused are recycled easily. Institutional commitments. So the whole society, NGOs and the government should support and commit themselves for the sustainable use of resources. It is not the responsibility of one person. So everyone, all the people, NGOs and the government should support and commit themselves for sustainable use of resources. Interdependence. So the cause of sustainability should not only be taken within the country, but also it should be mutual transboundary cooperation, because environmental problems like global warming, climate change and other issues are problems. They are the global issues which need international commitment and support. So now let us discuss about Gandhiji's ideas of village self-sufficiency. Gandhiji's idea of village self-sufficiency, or how the villagers can achieve the self-sufficiency. So according to Gandhiji, everyone should be provided with basic minimum necessities like food, shelter and clothing. So Gandhiji's strategies to create self-sufficiency, to increase village economy especially in agriculture, whatever the techniques we are using, that should not degrade the soil or deplete the soil, or it should not pollute the environment. The farmers, they should use the eco-friendly methods or eco-friendly techniques. That means by using lesser and lesser amount of chemical fertilizers, insecticides or pesticides, and with well irrigation instead of larger hydroelectric power projects. If they use well irrigation, so that will reduces the degradation of the land, and it also conserves the water. He was against the Jamindar system, because earlier due to Jamindar system, so it was affected to the, especially the poor people. So he was against the Jamindar system. The surplus lands should be distributed to the poor so that they can achieve the self-sufficiency. So surplus lands means the extra lands which can be distributed to the poor. In Gandhiji's view, every village should achieve sufficient growth. He believed that if every village distributes its surplus lands to poor villagers, then there will be no problem of poverty and starvation in the rural areas. He stressed more on the growth of rural small scale industries and cottage industries like khadi, handlooms, sericulture and handicrafts. So sustainable agriculture. What is the meaning of sustainable agriculture? So it is a type of agriculture which mainly focuses on the cultivation of crops with livestock, which causes minimum effects on the environment. So the type of agriculture which causes minimum effects on the land or soil and the environment is called a sustainable agriculture. Definitely it reduces the soil infertility, or it renews soil fertility. It conserves the natural resources. It reduces the use of non-renewable resources. It prevents degradation of our environment. Especially it controls the pests by natural biological method. It increases the productivity. It increases the productivity and also it increases the income of the farmers. So what are the methods of sustainable agriculture? So what are the methods of sustainable agriculture, or what methods we are going to use? From that we can achieve sustainability in agriculture. Crop rotation. So we are altering the crops every year so that it will reduce, it increases the fertility of the soil, and also it controls the pests. And planting cover crops, so using tillage, so extra unwanted plants we can reduce it. And especially we can integrating livestock, we can have integrating livestock and crops. So adopting agroforestry practices, because you know that agroforestry is a method of forestry in which not only we will carry out agricultural activities, with that afforestation programs will be carried out, and also livestock animal husbandry is carried out. So that definitely it will help in conserving the resources. So by this we come to the end of first part of evolving sustainable paradigm. In the next class we will continue with this lesson.